Hello friends, this is Tobias and today I will show you how to install Angband on Linux. This is very easy. You just go to your packet manager, Angband, and it will install. Even if you want to do something more complicated, you should do this first to get all the dependencies. Now, if your distro does not have 3.2, which is the latest stable version, or if you're under Windows, go to the site refile.org. It will have a Windows binary. It will have the source that you can just do aclocal configure make install. Then you have it. Under Windows, you just download the zip, unzip it, and then you can start it directly from the directory. Now we want to do some more interesting stuff. Go to development, get the address for the development version, which is newer. The regular version is old, and everyone who is scared of code should run away now and skip to the next video. I will only explain how to install in this video. Playing comes in the next video. So go, it will download. Download. Might take a while. I think it's faster to compile than to download. Now that you have it, you change in the directory. Then you can try out making it. You need first autogen. Then configure. Then make. Then you switch to root. And make install. I'm not gonna do this. Now, next step of fun is to change the code. So first we make a branch. It's useful to have a branch and a original copy on your system. Change to the branch, check out. Now we can change something. A change I usually had on my old install, but I didn't restore on this install, is that in Monster One there's a press damage, and as you know, it is not displayed if you don't know the monster's HP. So we change this so that we can listen to an airplane flyby by my window, or was it a helicopter? And this way we know the press damage as soon as a monster press on you. Useful. Now you need to commit it so that you can have all your changes locked nicely and can roll them back if you want to. And you can, for example, make a diff to the master version. Yay. Now here is one I prepared earlier. Git diff. I built my own copy of the staging version. Color diff, more useful. Now this is a lot of changes. First, my patch to recolor the monster list. My patch to recolor the speed display in the monster recall. Patch to change to add a relative speed display in the monster recall. Then the rest of my monster list recolor code. Well, Unix are still purple, summoners are bright red. Then not as scary summons are orange, stationary monsters are blue, fast guys are yellow, and monsters I haven't met in this playthrough are blue. Nice and useful. Then the rest of the install, and here my kpress logger, it's in term.set in the term kpress function. It will show you what which keys I press in the later playthrough. Now, if you are ready, you configure. You need to every now and then to make this clean, or at least make clean. I just made this clean, that's why it doesn't work. Then you need to rerun autogen and configure. I use no install, so I can play directly from the source directory. Make it a little bit faster. Sometimes you have strange problems if you don't make this clean, or at least make clean when you update, so you should do it every now and then. And then I don't need to install, I can just go to from here to source and the executable minus m, or rather here is its help screen. I say minus m sdl to start the sdl version. That's how it looks like. I will show you how to play in the next video. You can also start, for example, the curses version. You quit the game with Control X, by the way, if you accidentally get in and can't get out. There's also a GTK version, which I haven't compiled, and a normal X version. I prefer the SCL version. So, I think that's it for this install tutorial. And then goodbye.